not have a clan to help her hunt or protect her young when she's away. This is a big day for the cheetah mother. She's about to give her cubs a hunting lesson. But first, the young ones need to charge their batteries. Sprinting is thirsty work. The young cheetahs have a whole world to explore and need to learn which animals are prey and which are best left alone. Back at the river, the rhino and her mate have stumbled across something disturbing. With their poor eyesight, they can't quite make it out. But their excellent sense of smell leaves no doubt what it is. A buffalo carcass, several days old. The discovery has the rhino spooked. Predators don't normally hunt rhino. They're too big. But these nervous creatures would still rather be somewhere else. Unfortunately, they're now headed straight for the elephants, where the mood is lighter. They're the biggest of the Super Seven. Elephants are normally the ones who disturb other animals. Even babies can be a handful. This herd has only one real problem at the moment. A young bull elephant who's been acting up recently. He's now old enough to be on his own, and the adult females don't want him here anymore. Even though he's been pushed out, he doesn't want to leave. He's used to the good life. The young bull stays close to the herd, but he's under strict orders to keep his distance. Right now, he's very unpredictable. Something other animals need to be aware of. The rhino thinks she's found a quiet feeding spot, but she's mistaken. For a rhino with poor eyesight, it's impossible to tell whether the elephant is angry, amorous, or just playful. No one's waiting around to find out. The day is still young for the lions. They have no cares, no worries, content and confident that the world is theirs for the taking. Just one lion is a powerful hunter. A whole pride, however, is a force to be reckoned with. This is their turf. And everyone knows it. This afternoon, all the females are together. The pride's two males are off patrolling the area, while one plays sentry, his brother lets everyone know who owns this territory. Even big cats don't like water. But there's only one way back to his brother. The lion's roar is a simple but effective way to announce himself. He can be heard 8 kilometers away. The leopard hears him, and no doubt, so do plenty of potential prey. With sundown approaching, the leopard knows this is the time to make his move. He is perfectly at home in the trees. No other African big cat can climb like this. The leopard has strong claws and incredibly powerful legs that can... It's been 3 days since he last fed. The late afternoon shadows will be perfect cover. The buffalo can't stay long in the water. They don't want to be caught here at night. They must drink their fill and be gone. For the pregnant cow, the water is a great relief, helping her take off some weight. For the rest, life is good, with only a few minor irritations. This lazy afternoon wallow is a favorite buffalo pastime. This would be paradise if it wasn't for a few unwanted neighbors. The leopard is headed their way. And from the other direction comes one of the lion brothers. This isn't good. Just one spooked buffalo can start a panic. The pregnant cow must stay with the herd at all costs. Any sign of weakness could spark an attack. Fortunately, the lion brother is just passing through. But it's time for the buffalo to be on their way to the higher grassland where the nighttime temperature will be warmer and it will be easier to protect themselves. They don't need the chilling lion's roar to remind them to move. The two brothers are in peak condition, but only rarely display their awesome power. They prefer to let the female seize the day and only show up when dinner's served. Back at the pride, the lionesses have a rude awakening. The bull elephant has decided to throw his weight in their direction. He's not showing signs of aggression yet, but he's uncomfortably close. And obscured behind the bush, the lions may not know till it's too late if he charges. Best to give him a wide berth and take the cubs too. The lions aren't happy about being moved on, but every cloud has a silver lining. descends. Lion. Elephants don't like lions. It's a very old law of nature. But the bull is more intent on a sand bath than taking on the pride, at least for now. As if to make his point, he strolls right back through the rest stop. He knows there's nothing they can do. Malamala's higher ground is the preferred habitat for the cheetah. This is covered by open grassland, perfect for the world's fastest sprinter. This is one of the mother cheetah's favorite hunting spots. It's also a safer place for them to bed down for the night. The cubs have yet to make their first kill, but they have each other to practice their moves on. All this playing doesn't amuse their mother. A quick nip puts them in order, if only for a moment. With sundown approaching, it's time for the hyena mum to get moving. Her cubs have drunk their fill. She needs to restore her milk supply with a good feed. The cubs will stay behind. They know the routine. And besides, after feeding so much today, all they'll want to do is sleep. The herd has reached the safety of the grassland, all but the pregnant cow. She's still lagging behind and must draw on all her reserves to catch up. Nor will the leopard. He's still following the impala. And the hyena, on the prowl for her next meal, has picked up his trail. The lions are up and ready to go. One last drink and they're off into the night. A force of nature, hungry and searching for prey. But can still monitor their movements by smelling their scent. Lions have a specialized smelling organ on the roof of their mouth. The pride. He is hungry. He'll let the females do the dirty work though, and turn up just in time to eat. The lionesses don't have to go far before they pick up the scent of the pregnant cow. Now she has little time to reach the herd. The lions are intent on their prize. Not even a herd of impala can tempt them away from their mission. Up ahead, the tired but determined buffalo cow finally reaches the safety of her companions. Now it's time for the next exhausting challenge, to give birth. Adult buffalo are big and strong and have a mean temper. The lions will have to get past them to reach the cow, who is still some way behind them. This is the cow's most vulnerable time. The baby's on its way. Fortunately, buffalo mothers are designed to give birth quickly. Without hesitating, her offspring tries to get up onto his little legs. He won't be gambling about for at least a couple of hours. This is his most vulnerable time. The elephant herd is not far away. A chance encounter with the approaching lions could cause a big uproar. The herd is still moving through the bush, feeding. They'll feed for 16 hours a day to fuel their massive bodies. Only the bull elephant has settled down for the night. He's fast asleep. Now the lions have found the spot where the buffalo calf was born, and they have the young baby in their sights. This is a snatch-and-grab operation. First, send the buffalo into a panic, then rush in and pick off the baby. They close in, and the buffalo scatter, leaving the baby out front and vulnerable. But the mother's instincts won't let her leave her baby behind. And in just a few more moments, the herd rallies round. The larger buffalo have had enough of the lions and now turn on the hunters. The buffalo are too strong to penetrate without the help of one of the lion brothers. The lions have missed their opportunity. The calf is safe. Meanwhile, the leopard is in hot pursuit of the impala. Now that it's night and they're in thicker bush, he stands a good chance of making a kill. And the hyena is now tailing the leopard. She's big and strong enough to steal a kill from him. Much easier than catching one herself. All she has to do is wait. The impala knows something's up, but they can't see the danger. When they finally do, it's too late. The leopard tries to kill silently, but the impala's cries echo through the night. Just what the hyena's been listening for. Leopards often take their kills up into the trees to avoid other predators. But this cat is so hungry, he starts his meal on the ground. A mistake. Not only has he angered the elephant with all this commotion, the hyena is also onto him. With the hyena. All he can do is watch her steal his meal. But the hyena is headed for a nasty shot with the elephant. And she drops the prize. The leopard acts quickly and regains his meal. Thank you. He's not going to waste his second chance. Only leopards are strong enough to carry a kill into the trees. A hyena may be fierce, but it can't climb. In no time, the leopard is on to his second course. There's nothing the hyena can do but hope for a few scraps from the table. The leopard thinks he's safe, and he should be. But now several tons of trouble are bearing down on him. The disturbed elephant is on the warpath, to the delight of the hyena. Now it's time for her to do what hyenas do best, and steal an opportunity. Not quite a whole impala, but better than nothing. The elephant has made his point. The leopard is left shaken, but still in possession of his meal. The lions may have been thwarted by the buffalo, but they now have a new target to round off their evening's entertainment. Wildebeest. This is what makes the lion the most fearsome of Africa's Super Seven. The pride working together to bring down an animal much bigger than any single lion.